You may be wondering what it's like running Bazzite OS on a Legion Go. I'm going to show you how I installed it, what it was like using it, and how I added a launcher for Epic Games, plus some shortcuts for YouTube and Xbox Cloud Gaming. First, I want to briefly start at the Bazzite download page. Bazzite will provide tailored download information based on the device you plan to install it on. I selected Legion Go. Then for desktop environment, I selected KDE like SteamOS. Bazzite highlights that keeping the BIOS updated on the Legion Go may require dual booting Bazzite with Windows. Fortunately, there is a workaround that allows you to update the BIOS with Bazzite installed without needing to set up a dual boot. After downloading Bazzite, I needed to create a bootable thumb drive by burning the Bazzite ISO onto it. I'm using a dock as well as a wired keyboard and mouse for most of the install. To burn the ISO, I used Rufus, which can be found in the Microsoft Store. Rufus automatically recognized my USB drive. I just pressed select, navigated to the Bazzite ISO in my downloads folder, clicked on open, then selected start. I selected the recommended write in ISO image mode and agreed that all data on the USB would be destroyed. Rufus stated ready once it was finished and I removed my USB. Okay, I'm going to install Bazzite onto my Legion Go, but I'm not going to use the SSD that's currently in here. I'm going to use a different one. Hold on for just a second, let me go grab it. When I first got my Legion Go, I upgraded the internal storage to 2 TB. I then used an adapter to upgrade it to 4 TB. This is the original 2 TB SSD I installed. It's from a company called Inland. Although I upgraded my SSD, I never had a problem with this while I was installed in my Legion Go. The Legion Go is probably one of the easier handheld devices to disassemble, since you can remove the controllers and lay it flat on a surface. Then it's just a matter of taking out the 6 screws on the back and prying it open. The initial prying was probably the hardest part for me. But once I selected the right tool, I was able to get it open with a little bit of patience. My dbrand skin did suffer some damage during the process, but better the skin than the device. I used my pry tool to disconnect the battery. I unscrewed and removed the old SSD, then the adapter. Before installing the 2 TB SSD, I added a piece of thermal tape to the top of it. I replaced the SSD and screwed it into place. I used my pry tool to plug in the battery. I reinstalled the back cover. I'll replace the screws after I make sure everything works. Next, I had to install Bazzite onto my Legion Go, so I inserted my USB drive and held down the volume up and power button. On the pop-up screen, I selected boot menu, then my USB flash drive. You can't really see it here, but on this next screen, I selected install Bazzite OS. Bazzite went through its install process. I selected my language, and on the next screen, the device where I wanted to install Bazzite. I got a message saying I didn't have enough space, so I just clicked the reclaim space button, then I clicked delete all, and then reclaim space again. I next created a user account for my system, then pressed begin installation at the bottom right. This part did take a while, so these aren't sponsors. I'm trying to snack healthier. Since I started making YouTube videos, I've gained a few pounds. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button. It helps the channel. It finished faster than I thought, so I removed my USB and clicked on the reboot system button. After a couple of minutes and a couple of reboots, I eventually got to this blue screen and selected continue boot. Bazzite took me to its desktop and I went through Bazzite's setup utility. I kept getting a pop-up suggesting I install a KDE wallet, and I just X'd out of that. I didn't install it. Once everything was done installing, I pressed return to gaming mode. Bazzite took me to Steam. I went through the standard Steam startup process. I logged into my Steam account and began downloading games. Now that I have Bazzite installed, I want to go over the controls and then show you some games. When I installed Bazzite, I was already familiar with Steam's controls. Pressing the top left button brought up the Steam's main menu, while the right button opened the quick settings. When I double tapped the quick settings, I gained access to the TDP controls, allowing me to adjust the TDP up to 30 watts. I also had control over the fan settings. I was surprised to discover that pressing the right back button also accessed the TDP controls, and the left back button opened the on-screen keyboard. which was very useful when I was in the store and looking for a game. Okay, let me show you some games, and after that, I'm going to install a launcher so I can play my Epic games. During this brief demo, I'm playing with 6GB of RAM dedicated to the GPU, and at 20 watts turbo. The first game is Black Myth Wukong. In case you are wondering, the Legion Go does work with Bazzite without the controllers attached. I purchased this Jsaux Handle Kit for my Legion Go. It uses magnets to connect the left and right controller together so they feel like one controller. It also comes with a silicone protected cover that fits over both of them. This setup made me feel like I was using a standard controller. Using the two together was more comfortable and really enhanced my gaming experience. The Jsaux kit also came with a magnetic support base, which allowed me to play games in FPS mode. I could also use the right controller as a fully functional mouse in Bazzite's desktop mode. The M1 button works as a left mouse click. The M2 button works as the right mouse click. I could use the wheel on the right controller to scroll through a web page. M3 is the forward button. Y3 is the back button. I had to tap into the typing box to bring up the on-screen keyboard, but once I did, I was able to use my controller in order to type. Now don't get me wrong, I don't think that using the Jsaux kit is as good as using a standard controller like this one for the PS5, or a gaming mouse, but I will say that I really like the fact that if I'm traveling with my Legion Go, I don't have to carry a controller or a gaming mouse with me. I can just carry the Jsaux kit, and the silicone cover? That's optional. Before installing Heroic Launcher, I want to quickly talk about battery life. I want to show you how long the battery lasted with my usual settings. I played each game with 6GB of RAM dedicated to the GPU and at 20 watts. I started with Warframe at 10:27 AM. My battery was at 98%. I next moved on and played a game of Helldivers 2. And then a little bit of Kingdom Hearts. When I finished playing at 11:44 AM, my battery was at 11%. Just to recap, I started at 10:27 AM with 98% battery. I finished at 11:44 AM, giving me a total time on game of 1 hour and 17 minutes. My remaining battery life, 11%. I've been playing Epic games through Heroic Launcher, and honestly, it's super easy to install. First, I had to go back to desktop mode. I went to the Discover icon on the toolbar, and I searched for Heroic Games Launcher. I just pressed Install. Then I pressed Launch, and logged into my Epic Games account. I then went into Steam and added Heroic as a non-Steam game. I went back into gaming mode and I was able to find Heroic Launcher under non-Steam games. Then it was just a matter of going into my Epic account and downloading games onto my device. Not every game worked with Heroic Launcher. Several games had anti-cheat software attached that didn't allow me to play them. But there were a bunch of games that did work, and they all started and played just fine. Adding a YouTube shortcut to Steam was really easy with Bazzite. From the desktop mode, I searched for web apps, which allows you to run a website as an app. I typed in YouTube, then I copied the YouTube URL from Firefox and pasted it under address and hit OK. I went to my Steam account and added it as a Steam game. Then I went back into gaming mode and found it added to my non-Steam games. I also adjusted my controller settings. I used the EmuDeck controller hotkeys template. I set my A button to work as a left mouse click and my B button to work as a right mouse click. Then I set my directional pad to scroll up and down. As a result, I was able to easily access YouTube from gaming mode, find and navigate to my favorite channel, and watch videos. It wasn't perfect. When I tried to press the full screen button, it wouldn't work. However, I was able to get a larger picture when I pressed the theater mode button. Also, the back button didn't immediately take me back to my previous page. It brought up an on-screen pop-up that I used to go backwards. That being said, I found this far better than having to go to desktop mode to access YouTube. Installing a shortcut for Xbox Cloud Gaming was a little bit more involved, but to me, it was well worth it. I had to go back into desktop mode, then I went back into Discover, and I searched for Microsoft Edge. After installing Microsoft Edge, I went to the Start menu and added it to my Steam account. I opened up Bazzite's terminal. Then I opened up Firefox and went to the webpage I used as a guide. I copied the following script from the webpage and pasted it into the terminal. I hit enter, then typed exit to leave the terminal. I went back into Steam, right-clicked on Microsoft Edge, and went to Properties. I changed the name of the shortcut to Xbox Cloud Gaming. Then I went back into Firefox and copied the following code from the tutorial. I pasted the code at the end of the existing command in the Launch Options box, and I made sure that there was a space in between the two commands. I then went to my shortcut, right-clicked, and went to Manage and Controller Settings. I made sure controller layout was set to gamepad. I returned to gaming mode and found the shortcut I created in non-Steam games. I pressed play to start, then logged into my Microsoft account and was taken to the Xbox Cloud Gaming homepage. Xbox Cloud Gaming is an additional feature included with my Game Pass Ultimate subscription. I don't have to download or update any games since I'm playing everything off of Microsoft servers. I can also play on various non-Windows devices like my iPad and iPhone. It does cost $20 a month, and the quality of my gameplay depends on my internet connection. Every so often I'll get some slight stutter or lag, but for the most part I've been able to play the majority of the games that I like. Okay, so do I recommend installing Bazzite OS on a Legion Go? I think Bazzite OS is a great choice for tech enthusiasts and gamers who like customizing their devices. If you love tinkering with your gear, you're tired of Windows, and you want a more streamlined gaming experience, Bazzite OS could be a perfect fit for you. If you prefer a plug-and-play solution and get frustrated with troubleshooting your devices, then Bazzite OS might not be the right solution. There are compatibility issues for certain games and applications, and you could run into stability issues like bugs or crashes. Additionally, there's a learning curve to familiarize yourself with its interface and features. For me, I have thoroughly enjoyed having Bazzite on my Legion Go, and I'm going to keep it there for a while. There are links to tutorials and additional information in the description below about installing Bazzite OS. I'll see you in the next one.